Matt. Okay, so a girl sent me
an email
with the website of Heath's truck. It's different color rooms and everything, but it's the same VIN number.
What?
It's being sold in Florida right now.
How? Wait, it's already in Florida?
I mean, that's what we're guessing right now, but baby, we found the truck!
Oh my God!
But here's the thing, I showed Heath the website and he said he saw those pictures when he bought the truck in the first time. Shows 65,000 miles and that's what the mileage was when he first bought the truck. But the girl searched the VIN number on this site and she said that the VIN number states that it was purchased 20 minutes ago, wherever the truck is.
So wait, it might not be in Florida or it is in Florida?
It might not be in Florida, but the VIN number states that it was purchased 20 minutes ago.
Oh shit! Oh man, okay. What's this website? What do we gotta do now?
Okay, so Heath and I are going to the police right now to give him the footage. We're gonna tell them what the girl just sent us. Where are you right now?
At my apartment.
Oh, okay, you wanna come with us?
Yeah, I'm down.
Hello, Carly and Concha. The vlog sure misses you. Yeah, and it's nice to see you finally, you know, take a break from your boyfriend to hang out with me. Most of the time, she's like, you know, doing shit with her boyfriend, going to Universal every other day, which I never understand
I
why you do
are
that.
You're coming off jealous.
Look, I don't understand how someone can go to Universal
I
once a
don't
week.
Either. I just, here's the thing. Passes are so expensive. We got seasonal passes, which are like $3 more expensive than one day pass, so we got our money's worth by going 8 times a week. I only go because he loves it so much. I'm literally that good of a person.
Aw, you're such a good girl. I mean, by the way, how are you and Bruce doing?
Honestly, really good. A lot of his clothes fit me exactly. Like, it's literally perfect.
All you care about is his clothes. You don't care about, like, him.
I do, but I have Aaron's closet that I can pick from. Now I have Bruce's. I have my own best relationship I could ever think of. Bruce and I are the exact same size in jeans. So these pair of jeans I put on one time and I was like, Bruce, I need them. And there are times where he'll come over and I'll be like, I love that shirt. And he'll be like, Carly, fuck off. Because he knows I'm gonna steal it. We actually argued about it. Like, actual arguments for it. It was such a big thing that on my birthday he gave these to me. And I was happy about it. And not even because, like, oh, my boyfriend wore them. But I was like, I fucking love these jeans. Most girls take their boyfriend's, like, hoodies. But I take, like, his actual clothes.
Boyfriend goals. He's wearing a size 00 jeans.
Have you heard of the whole Avril Lavigne thing? It's like trending on Twitter right now. It's this whole conspiracy theory.
Is she dead?
Bear with me right now. Uh-huh. She died in like 2007 or something, and she has a replacement person that has taken over her career. It's interesting though, because when she started to get really famous, she had a body double that would go around. I can't believe we're Shane Dawson right now. So there's a girl, her name is Melissa Vandella.
Okay.
This girl was hired when Avril Lavigne got really popular to walk around and like have the paparazzi follow her so like the attention would be off of Avril because she looked so much like her. So this is Avril at the time, right?
Okay.
And this is her body double at the time.
Whoa.
Literally the exact same.
Like the same lips
they
and everything.
Exactly the same. So right after, I think her first or second album came out, her grandpa died. And there are videos of her on stage like sobbing and singing because like she couldn't get over it.
Yeah.
Because they were really close. And the theory is that she killed herself around that time. And the label company was like, oh my gosh, she's growing right now. Like, we can't do this. I don't want to tell anyone. So they hired this girl to literally go in her place and just be Avril Lavigne. It's weird when you dive into it because a lot of things are weird. But at the same time, it's like she probably just grew up. Like a lot, it's like her stage presence was so different. Like she used to dress this way and now she's like in dresses and she sings differently. Maybe this is what happened to David. Maybe like at some point he died and someone else came along that was like fucking evil. Like, I'm gonna bring a tarantula.
Where's David? We miss him.
Because of this, a conspiracy breaks out that David died like 2 years ago. Right when the vlogs came out. An interviewer asked and was like, so there's theories that you're dead. And she got real awkward and she was just like, I'm here. Which is like very weird.
I think that we need to start having stunt doubles also just so we can post more videos a week. Instead of posting twice a week, I'm gonna start posting 5 times a week. Looks like completely different people, but at the same time.
I feel like this was 10 years later. So maybe she just grew up and grew out of like the punk phase.
And people were just like making it with something. I don't know.
Probably. Fine.
Update on the truck. We wanted Heath to join us on this little update that we wanted to give you, but ever since this whole Big Red missing case, he's been ditching us for other people, and you know.
And meanwhile, we're the ones who are staying up into the wee hours of the night, hunting, searching, looking at every corner around in Los Angeles, trying to find this truck.
You guys sent us so many emails.
Thank you so much.
You guys sent us so many tweets, so many links, so many different sites that may have the truck on there. I've never seen more red trucks in my entire life than this past week. A lot of you're sending us the same links as other people because someone will put it in the comments, one link that they think it's it, and then all of you guys would see that link because it has a lot of likes on it. It would send us the same link. So just let everybody know all the links that you see in the comments, all the links that you've been sending us, none of them are you know, Heath's truck. Even if they do really look like them, they're not Heath's truck. And also, the people that own those trucks on those sites are getting a bunch of calls from you guys, and you guys are all saying that you stole Heath's truck when it's not Heath's truck. And they actually called Heath and told him, for us to let you guys know that, like, just to stop calling them. They just don't understand why so many people are calling him.
Thank you, though, for looking. Main things, though, that some people are missing when it comes to these trucks are the details. And the details are, Heath's truck had black side mirrors. Some of the trucks that, you know, are being sent to us have red side mirrors. Heath's truck does not have over 100,000 miles.
Yeah, and it does not, he does not have his back either. So if you see a truck with a red back on it, like, you know, the top, he doesn't have that either.
I don't know. I have like a good story of the investigation. Right. The day Heath got back in town, he asked me like, what leads do we have? Yeah. The only lead I had was that the robber came on a bike. Yeah. He stole Heath's bike, came on a bike. And so I was thinking he must live around in the neighborhood. Mm-hmm. You know, he had no getaway car and he had that camo backpack on. I'm thinking in my mind, on a bike, lives locally, wears a backpack, they go to school.
And he had a little, you said he had a little lanyard too.
In some parts it looks like she has it, but I don't know what these high schoolers were doing up at 4 in the morning on a school night.
That's what we're more worried about. What the hell are you doing at 4 in the morning on a school night? Not stealing other people's car. What the hell are you doing out of school at 4 in the morning?
So I look up the local high school. It's just a few blocks away from me. And I look up the bell schedule on the website.
Matt.
I called up the school. I like was on Google Earth, like looking up where the bike racks were. I'm figuring we need to do a little stakeout.
Okay.
Go to when school gets out.
But before we continue, him and Heath both went on a stakeout. I had stuff to do.
Yeah, you had stuff to do.
I had stuff to do, so they both went.
So yeah, Heath and I get in his truck and we go to the local high school. Oh, and I even called the school before. And I was like, because I couldn't find the bike rack on Google Earth.
Oh
and
my
god.
So
I said, hi, and I called the front office. Like, she's like, hi, this is the high school. And I'm like, hi, I'm in a real big hurry. I'm on my way to the high school and I need to park my bike. Where is the bike rack on campus?
You made your voice a little like squeakier.
Yeah, just like, hey, I'm just like, I'm really frustrated. I'm kind of new to the neighborhood. I'm a new student. And luckily she didn't ask like, well, what's your name? What are you coming to campus for? She told me exactly where the bike rack was.
Damn, good security.
Not good enough. Heath and I get there. We bring backpacks
to blend
ourselves in. Heath had sunglasses on because I didn't want him to get recognized. And I'm wearing like Scotty's merchant stuff.
I even saw you guys leaving. I'm like, why the hell are you guys wearing David's merch? When you want to cover up, but you also want to get recognized.
We get there. Heath is like about to start smoking. I'm like, Heath, you can't smoke on campus. Put the cigarettes away.
Just walking through the halls.
Just like, I'm like, the campus police officer is right there. We wait like around like the bushes and we hear the bell ring and we're like, let's go. So we walk up, we keep our heads low and we just sit there and we just look at every student's back as they walk out looking for the camouflage backpack.
Uh-huh.
But then like 5 minutes in, I mean, it was a lot of students. Keith started feeling really bad. Like he started feeling like these kids are way too young to like be robbing or like they're not thieves. And like I kind of got that feeling too. Cause I mean, like high school kids are like young kids.
You don't realize how young high school kids are. These kids, I think, are like in college. They're definitely sophomore or juniors in college.
Definitely. So that's what we kind of got to that realization when we were there, that these kids just seem too innocent. And I saw a few camo backpacks, but none of them were that.
You went right up to them and,
come here. And it's just like a little tiny kid. He's just like, what? I don't know.
You're like, where were you 4 in the morning?
That's basically what I wanted to do. So we spent about 10 minutes there and like there were teachers. The principal was the walkie-talkie doing the carpool, but we're just like. I went in the front office. I asked to speak to the campus police officer. He wasn't there, which means we need to go again and just show him the backpack and go keep an eye out. It's a very specific backpack.
I actually forgot to mention this in the last video, but I called 911. I live in LA. I called 911 about 12 to 13 times and nobody answered. Like, this is supposed to be an emergency hot. Like, you call this number when you're in trouble. If you think you're about to be murdered, you call 911. If you think anything bad is about to happen, you call 911.
And you expect them to answer and be there pronto.
None of them answered. They put me on hold for 15 minutes until a lady answered 911 emergency. Even the way she said it was that there was no 911 emergency. I was like, hello? Yes, I've been on hold for 15 minutes. My friend's truck has just been stolen. Blah, blah, blah. Like, what do we do? Here's his like info. It's like, all right, sir, let me transfer you to someone that can help you. Puts me on hold again for like 10 more minutes and nobody responded, so I hung up.
That
this
is
blows
LA,
my mind.
That is LAPD for you. They will only help you if someone's been murdered or there's crack involved.
But what if I was getting murdered 15 minutes later? man, there's someone outside my house. I think they're trying to murder me. Let me transfer you to somebody that can help you. Oh. LAPD, get your shit together, because that is ridiculous that I had to call 13 times and still nobody answered. One person answered the 13th time. Ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
That's ridiculous. We finally got the footage. I was able to compile it all together. You know, the moment they walk and all angles to the moment they leave with the truck, all angles. Give it to the police. Like, it just, like, the whole vibe is just, like, you know, basically
see
kid,
this, they were like, we see this all the time.
And, man.
Good luck. Maybe it will turn up. Apparently, LA has this new license plate detector that can really identify cars that have been stolen. And yeah. So they're optimistic about that. But other than that, they don't really seem that, like, amped on the case.
And, you know, it's right. You know, they should be focusing more, like, you know, murders. And, like, I feel like after this happened, how many people didn't care that this happened? I feel like it just makes it okay that people can steal other people's cars and then just continue
get away with it.
And get away with it.
But what was also interesting, near the high school are a whole bunch of chop shops, sketchy car mechanics, like places where they just salvage old cars, all of these garages, all near the high school. So I'm thinking, like, that student or whoever it was took it right there. They wouldn't have been on the major highway. So I was driving around all of these back alleys looking for the truck. Saw nothing. Like, apparently, those stolen cars, most of the time, they steal it and put it in, like, a shipping container, leave it in a parking lot for, like, months, and then they sell it overseas.
Hmm. So something tells me that we gotta do a little stakeout.
A little stakeout. Go down to the ports.
Mm-hmm. Try to find this truck. Alright, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more stuff from me and all my friends. Shout of the week goes to Chris. Thank you so much for keeping up with all my stuff and watching all my videos. I really appreciate it. Now, you should have seen it. The last video I posted, the last shout out I gave, was a girl with wavy hair with a hood over.
No.
And everybody was in the comments like, Zane, did he just expose the girl that stole his truck? And I go back, I'm like, oh my god, how did I not notice that?
The girl who actually stole the car realized she stole Heath's truck, watches your videos, and is already like, then at the end she sees the shout out and is like, oh.
We start making conspiracies about our friends.
'Cause a different girl.
He just grew up and, like, grew out of the punk thing.